finally at the finish line. Yeah!
You did it! You finished the whole of the London Tube map.
So running the London Tube map took me, I think it was like 55 or 56 days. And it was a total of 820 miles, which I think is like 1,320 kilometers. I think that's like the total distance from St. Ives to Jawn or Groats. Like it's quite a lot. My name is Matt Nelson, and I have ran the London Tube Map. One of the inspirations for me to run the London Tube Map, it was when I first moved to London in February of 2017. I've always had a love for running, and I've always had a love for railways and metro systems and transport maps. There was one time I was having an interview, and there was a question that was asked that was like, what are some of your greatest achievements in life? And what was your proudest moment? I don't know, I just always felt anxiety whenever I heard that question, because like I've had successes throughout my life, but I always felt like as if they were off the backs of other people. I never really felt like as if it was my thing that was like me personally, like doing something. When I was getting off the tube at, I think it was Ealing Common, I remember staring at the tube map. And that was when I had the inspiration of, that's when it clicked for me, of like, has anybody like ran the tube map before? And it turns out that a few people have. People have walked the entire London tube map as well. And I didn't really see anything on YouTube at the time to have like a visual documentation. And so that was one of the inspirations to go out and do it. And I did. Runderground was born.
So to give you a brief rundown as to what Runderground is, I took on the challenge in 2017 to run to every station that features on the London Tube map. So I'm doing the Underground, Overground, Dyalla, Elizabeth Line, trams, and the cable car. I think that's it. Yeah, I think that's it.
Hey,
we're here at Haring Cross.
I've never seen that in my life.
We're getting close to Chingford now.
Quite a lot of police around.
F***ing s***ing myself.
Oh, it stinks of you.
It took me around 2 attempts to do. The first time was, of course, back in 2017. And the second attempt was in 2020. But what ended up happening the first time, I was doing way too much, way too quickly. I was trying to cram in all of the runs together and do it as like, I don't know, like in my head, I felt like as if it was like a tour. It was like having this like one run and then straight into the next one, straight into the next. And I didn't allow myself much time to recover. And that was to my own detriment. And I was in so much pain. In particular, it was with my knee. I should have done the sensible option of just stop running. I'm quite a stubborn person. I was like, no, I'm just gonna just keep on going, just keep on going. It turned out that I'd damaged some cartilage on my knee from doing all the intense running and from the lack of training. I couldn't run for, I think it was about a year. I couldn't run properly. And to make a full recovery, it took a year and a half. So any time that I would go out for a run, I would be wearing a knee brace. And yeah, I did that for a long time. It was actually thanks to parkrun that helped me get to the point of where I'm at now, because before I had an emphasis with parkrun of like trying to get a fast time and like all this other stuff. But once I had my injury, my perception of that changed, where I then participated in parkrun with the intention of doing it not to get a fast time or to get a PB, but the goal was to improve my fitness, to like rehabilitate myself. So by the end of 2019 was when I made a full recovery and I could run without my knee brace.
Deep breaths, good lad.
And yeah, by 2020 I was actually in even better fitness than I was before, which yeah, is a very full circle moment. It was, yeah, very, very proud of myself for that.
When you're rolling. So we're at the Vitality Heart. And on scene four, I should see you.
But then, of course, with 2020, that was a bit of a head punish. But I knew that from being in lockdown, for me, I felt like as if there was like a timer going off in my head, thinking that, you know, I needed to be doing something with my time. That's when I knew that it was a make or break moment, whether I was going to fully commit to doing the Runderground challenge or not. During my lockdown, I had spent time planning all my routes. I'd also reached out to friends to help me design logos, and my partner Josh, and did some of the music, like with the theme music. While Josh has been working on the song, I've just had the email come through from the designer with the logo. And yeah, it just felt like this big operation was taking place, and it felt so exciting to get all of that going. And then on the 22nd of May 2020, I found myself at Roding Valley running the Hainaut Loop on the Central Line, and that was officially day one of Runderground.
This is the thing with Runderground. It's not about getting the fastest time or like running from station to station the quickest time or anything. It's just literally going from station to station, line to line on a tube map. And that's it. There's nothing really much else to it.
I guess the most challenging section of running the London tube map, I think that quite honestly depends on many other different factors. I think that it's not so much the section in of itself. Usually when I was plotting the routes, I stuck to around like 20, maybe like 30 kilometers. But the thing that was the most adverse was the weather. Nearly 11 o'clock, like 26 degrees, I think it is.
Heathrow terminal four. Definitely not running out in this.
But in my opinion, I think the most challenging to run was the Piccadilly line. And I say that because it was mostly due to its lack of change in terrain for me. I remember running the last section of the Piccadilly line and just like saying to the camera, saying it out loud, I'm just like, oh God, like everything hurts, like this hurts.
Everything hurts.
Like I was really hitting the wall during that. And I guess that's why it's such a complex question of like, you know, what's the most like challenging tube line? What's the most like challenging section? Sometimes like, it's down to your mental game as well. Sometimes when you wake up, you feel like really strong and really empowered and that you feel like you can tackle anything. But there are some days where you just don't want to do it, but you know that you have to do it. That's when I was more notorious for like having a lot of negative self-talk. Which I learned that the key about getting around that is just being even kinder to yourself. And not just like as you're running, but even just in regular life as well. I think practicing a lot of positive affirmations also, I mean, it has a huge effect on your mental health overall. I think that that has really shaped my resilience when it comes to like doing challenges like this. I know that if I didn't have the positive self-talk, that I wouldn't have been able to do this challenge. 2017, when I first attempted this, was a product of that. Practicing self-love isn't just like pushing through pain or anything. Self-love is about recognizing that you're in pain and being kind to yourself and being like, okay, I need to like, let's take a breather. Let's, you know, take it easy. And if we need to stop, that's absolutely not a problem. And I made no apologies about doing that. If I needed to like stop a run early or for whatever circumstance, I was never hard on myself to be like, oh, I have to do this thing. I have, because it's just not, it just doesn't feel fun by that point. It doesn't feel fun. By the time that I was home, I'd take a shower and I would do a lot of yoga as well. And even just taking a moment just to like say thank you to my body and just being like, being grateful for you know, like, hey, like, I did that thing today, I did that run, that went really well. And even if it didn't go well, it's like, but hey, I still did the damn thing anyway. I think from having that view of myself, I think that that really shaped, I don't know, I think that shaped a lot of things for me.
My name is Matt, and I ran every line and station that features on the London Tube until Thameslink came along.
In December of 2020, it was announced that parts of Thameslink were going back on the Tube map.
22 years of not being on the Tube map, Thameslink is making a return.
I felt like as if on social media I was making like a big deal out of it, but in reality, I was actually really excited. I was really looking forward to seeing what Thameslink had to offer and seeing really what other parts of London had to offer as well. I think it was fantastic to see so many of the different parts of London being represented on the Tube map, with the Underground in particular, because there's a lot of North London representation. South London has been quite neglected, I feel. So to see Thameslink and showcasing like the South West, South East, I thought it was brilliant.
Since December of 2020, Thameslink is now officially back in the London Tube map.
Who needs Hollywood when you've got Cricklewood?
And that brings us to this monument here as a memorial for William Willett.
Can't believe it didn't click for me that Abbey Wood Station got its name because there was an abbey next to the wood.
Now we've got one more section left until I've ran the entire London Tube map. Absolutely unreal, I can't believe it.
It was day 55. And the last section was from Deptford to London Bridge. It was about like 6 kilometres. And I was supported by my partner Josh and my very good friend Matt. They wanted to support me running the very last section. And it was such a huge moment for me because it just didn't feel real. While running it, I was thinking about everything that had happened prior to that, through all of the pain, through all the struggle, through not being able to run for such a long time and then being able to run again. There was so much that was going on in my mind. And then by the time I got to London Bridge, I just completely broke down. I broke, like, yeah, I fully broke.
Finally at the finish line, yeah! Woo, woo, woo! Yeah!
You alright?
Yeah! You did it! You finished the whole of the London Tube map. Isn't that amazing? Yeah, yeah.
So proud of you. You did so well. What an incredible achievement.
It's not like tears of sadness, it's tears of joy.
Of course.
So proud.
You should be. It's amazing.
It was just such an overwhelming moment. It was such an overwhelming moment because this ambition that I set out to do 4 years ago, I finally achieved it. And my ambition of running the London Tube map had came true. No matter what happens, there's no circumstance that can ever come along that can ever take that away from me. And the fact that I did all of that during a pandemic as well was such an even bigger achievement in of its own right. But after I finished at London Bridge, I was actually surprised by a very special guest.
Who's this? Who's this? Are you that train person?
No, you're the running train person.
I don't know if you got the news, but I have ran the entire London Tube map.
What? Not everywhere?
Which is crazy, I know, right? Absolutely wild.
Well, I've got something for you.
Okay.
So,
are you Steve?
Yeah. So first of all, just a general well done. So we need to get a selfie of you holding this. You hold that.
Okay. We've got this.
I'm taking that. I've never... What a great selfie stick. And then, are you allowed to swear on your channel? There's always a joke. There's always a joke when someone says, you know, well, where's me medal? So what I've what I've done to say well done, I've actually got you an actual medal.
God.
So which that actually is, says winner.
Oh, love it.
So if you could wear the winner's medal.
Go. Okay, let's stick it on now. We've got this and we've got the medal as well. I feel like as if there's
something. But also, there's a genuine like, you know, you've done the whole tube mat, which is amazing.
Thank
I've got you from my private collection. Some tube maps from over the years that you can have and just I'm just gonna take a photo. Hang on, could you hold up your map? There we go.
And well done, mate. Are we allowed to do a COVID high five?
We'll do a COVID air five.
Shh.
Boom.
Run the ground.
Thank you so much. Like, thank you.
No.
Are you gonna cry again?
No.
Because to be honest, if it wasn't for Jeff, like I don't think that I would be on many people's radar.
As part of my Beat the Tube series, I thought I'd get my friend Matt.
Morning.
Hi.
Hey.
Matt's from the channel Runderground.
That really did put me on the map for a lot of people. And so I'm forever grateful to have had that opportunity. It was a very full circle moment to see him there. I thought that was fun. Though I guess now, when I say that I've ran the London Tube map, by the time this video goes live, that kind of won't be true. So when I was running the Northern line, I think it was the last section I did. It was from Morden to Kennington. But I did run an extra little bit from Kennington to Battersea Power Station. It's the newest extension to the London Tube map. That section was, I mean, it wasn't open to the public yet. So once this goes live, I kind of need to run that, which I'm kind of thinking of doing like right now. We're doing this now.
So just behind me is Kennington Station. We're about to run the Northern Line extension, thus completing running the entire London Tube map. Let's get cracking, Northern Line extension. Let's have it. Today's a very exciting day because it is the first major construction to have completed and opened on the London Underground in over 20 years. So there was no way that I couldn't come out on the official opening of this brand new extension. So it'll be very interesting to see the stations in action now. And we're here, so this is the brand new Nine Elms station. Has literally just opened today. It is so much different than compared to last time that I was here. On that note, we've still got one more station left. We're gonna be running over to Battersea Power Station Squared. Let's head over there. So taking 56 days and 823 miles of running, I've successfully ran, including the new Northern Line extension on the London Underground. My name is Matt and I've successfully ran the entire London Tube map. Yes.
All right. Now I've ran the London Tube map. I never really, from doing this challenge, I never would have realized just how much of an impact that it would have had on so many people. The amount of messages that I've seen that have inspired the number of people to start running again. And just to see so many people being inspired from what I do, I can't describe that feeling. It's one of the most humble experiences I've ever felt. But I guess now the big question is, what's next? I can say that I'm working on the next thing already. There is something coming very soon, which when it's ready, I'm very much looking forward to sharing. again to the supporters of Runderground for making this documentary possible. Show your support to the channel by checking out the merch store, link in the description, and subscribe for future videos.